If we wanted to get something all the way to another planet, why can't we just throw it in the right direction really hard? Sometimes working with gravity instead of against it is the easiest way to get something where we want it to go.
That's one small step for man.
Traveling through space is hard. That's why NASA's Space Launch System will have to be the most powerful rocket in the world. How is SLS able to meet the challenges of exploring deep space? Well, when it comes to our journey to Mars and beyond, there are no small steps.
So let's talk about orbit. We've covered how we initially escape Earth's gravity to get into space, but to stay there, we'll basically have to ride orbit. First, let's look at what that means if we want to send stuff to the International Space Station. For that, we'll need some help. Meet Terrence.
Here's Earth. And here's the space station's orbit.
Now let's say that we wanted to send a cargo capsule to the ISS.
If our capsule rode a vehicle straight up, then gravity would just pull it straight back down again. Instead, the vehicle needs to go sideways really fast as well as up. So fast that as gravity pulls it back down, it keeps missing the Earth instead.
That's orbiting, the art of constantly falling sideways.
Once we're in orbit, our vehicle fires its engines, pushing the opposite side of its orbit further away from Earth. This creates an elliptical orbit, better matching the ISS's. Once we match ISS, we fire our engines again to regain our circular orbit.
It's called the Hohmann transfer, and the same technique can get us to Mars. Let's reset the stage.
First, let's replace the Earth with the Sun, which both the Earth and Mars orbit around. Then let's scale things up. A lot.
Yeah, the Earth and Mars are a lot further apart than the Earth and the ISS. But with a powerful rocket like the SLS, we can make up the difference.
When we start our trip to Mars, we fire our engines strategically, spiraling further and further out, creating an elliptical curve that overlaps Mars' orbit. We coast until we get there, when we fire engines again to orbit Mars and eventually enter its atmosphere. Pretty simple, huh?
No? Well, at this point, it really is the easiest way to hop planets. It's also the most efficient. Imagine how much fuel we'd have to burn to push a rocket all the way to Mars. Why not just coast?
Another element to consider is distance. Every 2 years or so, for a short period of time, the Earth and Mars are as close together as they can be. This gives us a very narrow launch window. Launch too early or too late, and we don't have enough fuel, and the results could be disastrous.
The whole thing is like trying to hit a moving target while you're also moving, and you only get one shot.
Thankfully, the folks at NASA aren't just smart. They're patient and they're thorough. Next time, we'll talk about how the SLS is going to manage the long trip to Mars.
Thanks for watching No Small Steps. See you again soon.